Hey, everybody, I'm Charlie Belcher coming to you from the St. Petersburg Pier, where there is something new to see. It is a monument dedicated to the very first famous flight of commercial aviation that took off from this area, from St. Petersburg to Tampa, creating this back and forth flight that was really the birth of commercial aviation. And this art installment will make sure future generations know this story. Will Michaels knows all about this story as president of Flight 2014, which is a group that raised the money for this to happen. It's not a taxpayer thing, Will.
Oh, right. This is all privately supported here. Individuals, yeah. Businesses, organizations, airlines, the whole community came together and made this happen.
For people who don't know the history of commercial aviation and what a pivotal role St. Petersburg, Florida plays in it, give us a history lesson, Will.
Well, it all began right here. We had a fellow by the name of Percy Fansler, an engineer from Jacksonville, who came up with the idea of taking this early aviation back in 1914, these big biplanes flying around, mostly used as toys. And he thought, well, you can organize this into a business. You can organize this into a transportation business. So he came up with the idea of having a scheduled airline. And he pitched it to a fellow by the name of Tom Benoit. He was an airplane manufacturer in St. Louis. And Tom Benoit thought it was a great idea. So they said, let's do it. They came down here to Tampa Bay and ended up being headquartered right here in St. Petersburg. The original hangar was right on this spot.
Wow.
where the monument is up.
Yeah.
Not going up, but already up.
That's right. And, you know, people think it's hard to get across the bay back and forth in 2020. Much more difficult in 1914.
Well, Tony Jannus still has the record for getting from downtown St. Petersburg to downtown Tampa the fastest. 20 minutes. Sometimes he did it in 19 minutes.
That's fantastic. But yeah, no bridges then. You had to go up and around, right?
That's right. Yeah, you either went by boat, you could go by car, it would take you a whole day. Boat took you about 2 or 3 hours. There was a train, the Orange Belt Railway, but that took you about a day to get over to Tampa because they had to go back on the other side, the east side.
I know it's an exciting day for you. How thrilled are you to be able to look up and see this now finally in place?
Oh, we're just delighted to have it come in for a nice, smooth, happy landing here.
That's true. And now Tony Jannus is, he's not flying anymore. He's going to stay here for a while.
For a while, right, yeah. I think he's up there flying around someplace in the higher heavens.
Yeah, I think you're right. Will, thank you very much,
sir.
You're welcome. As you can tell, everybody involved with this project, they're definitely flying high today to see this finally come in for a landing, as Will said. You got to get to the St. Petersburg Pier and check it out. Charlie Belcher, Fox 13 News.